many ways is synonymous to Darjeeling, and every time I'm so glad to come back to this beautiful place. They have a bakery, patisserie and cafe at the ground floor, and all the confections and goodies look so yummy, you will feel like eating them all. The first floor has a proper full-blown restaurant, and we had our anniversary dinner there with wine, fish and chips and live music. Kunga is a small but must visit eatery near the mall, and it's always crowded. There's always a long line outside, so please make sure you have time on your hands when you want to eat at Kunga. The food is amazing. It's mainly Tibetan fare of momos and thuppas and spring rolls and soups, and it's yummy food, so make sure you go there at least once. Carpenters, of course, needs no introduction, because anyone visiting Darjeeling knows that it's a must visit place, famous for English food, British vibes and its own heritage. The rooftop or terrace sitting area is beautiful, and on a clear sky day you can actually see the Kanchenjunga range from there as well. We ordered fried sausages, fried eggs, french fries, sandwiches and breads, and it was a delicious brunch spread on our first day at Darjeeling this time. Shangri-La is a very well-known hotel in Darjeeling, and they are famous for their oriental cuisine. The place has an old world charm to it, with antique furniture, an actual fireplace and even bonfire outside around which you can sit and eat. We had steaming bowls of soup to brave the cold there, and we really enjoyed our evening at Shangri-La. The food we ordered, which was noodles and chicken, were also quite sumptuous, and the portions are really nice. So all in all, it's a great place if you like Chinese food. Margaret's Deck is a little known place which a lot of people might not know about. Well, it's a must visit place on your way up to Darjeeling or on your way down to the plains. It's a tea room come store that is run by tea giant Godrick, and the view from this place is amazing and insane. It's bang right in the middle of the hills. There's a beautiful deck where you can sit, and there's an indoor seating as well with old world English vintage vibes. They serve teas and sandwiches and cakes, and I must recommend the apple walnut cake, which was really surprising and yummy. Hope you enjoyed. Don't forget to like, subscribe and comment.